वंदे शंभुमापतिं सुरगुरुं वंदे जगत्कारणं
वंदे पन्नकभूषणं शशिधरं वंदे पशूनां पतिं वंदे सूर्यशशांकवह्निनयनं वंदे मुकुंदप्रियं वंदे भक्तजन आश्रयं च वरदं वंदे भक्तजन आश्रयं च वरदं वंदे शिवं शंकरं। फ्रेंड्स, इन द भगवद गीता वी हैव कर्मयोग। इन द कर्मयोग देर इज ए पर्टिनेंट पर्टिकुलर सिग्निफिकेंट इंपॉर्टेंट श्लोक and that shloka or stanza is often repeated. Karmanyevadhikaraste ma paleshu kadachana. Man, you have a right to work. Your duty is to work. You have a responsibility to do your duty. You don't have any right to demand the fruit. You are only to work. You cannot expect any fruit. You have no rights. Is it not meaningless? Right from morning till night we work hard. From 1st of every month till the 30th or 31st of every month we work hard. Should we not have a right to ask for the wages, salary? Can we work without expecting the fruit? Is it right on the part of Krishna to ask all people to work, work, work? Don't expect fruit, fruit, fruit. Action only you have to do. Activity only you have to do. There is no question of your demanding any fruit. This is the meaning of that particular sloka in the Karma Yoga. Karmanyevadhikaraste ma paleshu kadachana. You are only to do your duty, not to expect or demand any fruit thereof. Vigneshwara got the doubt. Vyasa Maharshi wanted to write Srimad Mahabharatam on the advice of Narada Maharshi. And he started writing. For that he found his hand to be a little slow. Therefore he requested God Brahma. Brahmaji, Brahmaji, I am unable to sit at the desk and take a pen and paper and write down the entire Mahabharata. The plot is available in my mind. I have the long story in my brain. I have to sit at the desk and make a writing of it. I find it a little difficult. Can you provide a good typist? I want a good stenographer. I will be dictating. I want somebody to take down. Then Brahma suggested and recommended, Vigneshwara is very good at writing. Why shorthand? In longhand itself, even a typist may take more time, a stenographer also may take more time, but Vigneshwara does not take any time. The moment you complete, his writing will be complete. So fast he can take down your dictation. You ask Vigneshwara, sir, if I ask, will he come? Okay, I will request on your behalf, I will send him to you. Brahma requested Vigneshwara, my dear Vigneshwar Vinayak, that Vyasa Maharshi is trying to write a huge book called Mahabharata. You please go and help him take down. Before Brahma, Vigneshwara said yes. But there was a little egoism. Who is that Rishi? After all, a scholar, after all, a professor, and I am the son of Lord Shiva, superior to Vyasa. And Why should I be placed on a subordinate role when he is dictating? I have to take down. But he cannot say no to Brahma. And he does not want to accept the job because taking down is the duty of, after all, a stenographer or a clerk or a typist. Vigneshwara cannot afford to be a mere typist. Therefore, he went to Vyasa with reluctance. He did not like the job. Maharshiji, Maharshiji. Yes, sir. You want me to take down? Yes, sir. But on one condition. What is that condition? My hand should not stop. I have a very fast handwriting. If my pen stops for want of dictation, if you are to dictate very slowly, I will not sit and write. My hand will be very fast. If you stop or wait for a moment, I will get out. I will not take down the notes. Then Vyasa said, Vigneshwaraji, very good. I shall try to be as fast as I can. And I am sure you will also take down very, very, very quickly. But there is another condition. What is that condition? Normally, typists type without understanding what they are typing. When you are copying down, you don't bother what you are copying. If there is a mosquito there, you will bring another mosquito here and paste it here. If there is a cross cut there, you will put another cross cut here. You don't have any brains. Normally, typists don't have brains. Stenographers don't have brains. Copying machines do not have brains. They are not intelligent. Vigneshwaraji, you are not like that. You are a great man. I am sure you will understand when I dictate my story. Without understanding, you should not write a single word. Vigneshwara thought, what do you think of me? I am capable of understanding all the languages on earth. My father is the architect of all the languages. When he gave that damaru, from one side Sanskrit was born, from the other side all the languages were born. My father was the originator of all the languages. I have learned all the languages. I can understand any language. You dictate. Without understanding, I will not take down. If you give me time to wait, I shall go away. Now the understanding is over. The agreement is over. There is a memorandum of understanding. Vyasa is to dictate. Vigneshwara is to take down. Vigneshwara has to take down every word to be understood by him before taking down. And Vyasa should not stop even for a fraction of a second. If he stops, Vigneshwara stops and go away. This is the understanding. Now Vyasa Maharshi was dictating, dictating, dictating without taking water, without eating, without breathing, without even thinking, so galloping, galloping, because Vigneshwara will run away. At one point of time, Vyasa thought, I must have a little time to compose next 1,000 slokas. Therefore, he created one powerful sloka. Vigneshwara would just think for half a minute to understand that. Within that half a minute, Vyasa would compose another 1,000 stanzas and he would dictate. These slokas are called Vyasa Ghattas. In Mahabharata, there are certain slokas which are very difficult to understand even for Vigneshwara. One such sloka is available in Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita is a part of Mahabharata. In the Bhagavad Gita, there is this sloka, Karmanyevadhikaraste mapaleshu kadachana. This particular part he has dictated and Vigneshwara stopped the pen. How foolish it is. You have a right to work, you have no right to demand the fruit. Is it not foolish? How can people believe Krishna to be a wise man? How can the entire philosophy be condensed in this particular stanza? This apparently appears to be very foolish, unpractical. After all, you go to the college, with the hope that you would get a degree. After all, you marry a girl with the hope that she would serve you food. After all, you marry a husband with the hope that he would get you the salary every first of the month. After all, you come to the Maitri Milan session with the hope. What is the fruit? Attendance. Attendance is the fruit. Attendance is the effect. Without attendance, why should I go to Maitri Milan? I go to the Maitri Milan only for one purpose, and I have attended the Maitri Milan, you have marked me absent, then you write, no, karmanyevadhikaraste, your duty is to attend the Maitri Milan, you have no right to demand attendance. Why should I attend Maitri Milan then? There is a question. See, when you do something, you expect something else to happen. Krishna himself in the Bhagavad Gita made many wonderful statements. Of them, two I will say. Number one, mama maya duratyaya. Arjun, my maya is impossible for anybody to overcome. You cannot cross. You cannot understand me. Mam eva prapadyante. Catch hold of my feet. Fall at my feet. Surrender yourself at my feet. Maya metam tarantite. I will take you beyond maya. It is very, very difficult to understand yoga. Yes. You fall at my feet. Yes. I will make you understand yoga. Understanding yoga is the fruit. Falling at the feet is the cause. Krishna himself says, mama maya duratyaya. It is impossible to understand my maya. It is impossible to overcome maya. It is impossible to go beyond maya. It is impossible to conquer maya. How is it possible then? What shall I do? Fall at my feet. Falling at my feet is the duty. Falling at my feet is your action. Falling at my feet is the means. What is the fruit if I fall at your feet? You will conquer maya. That means the fruit is prescribed by Krishna. The first part also is prescribed by Krishna. But you say earlier that mama maya karmanyevadhikaraste mapaleshkadachana, you have only the right to do, you have no right to demand the fruit. You are taking cause and effect. At the end of the Bhagavad Gita, there is another wonderful sloka. Sarva dharman parityajya. Action. Leave all activities. Give up all duties. Sarva dharman parityajya. Mam ekam sharanam braja. You fall at my feet. Surrender. What is the fruit? Moksha isyami masuchaha. I shall give you moksha. Moksha is the fruit. What is the work that you have to do? Fall at my feet. You say on one side, karmanyevadhikaraste mapaleshukadachana. On another place, you say, you do this, you will get that. You read any stotra. Yappate sivasannithav. Whoever reads this will get sivasannithya. We are reading every day Hanuman Chalisa. At the end, Palasruti is mentioned. Whoever reads this Hanuman Chalisa will have the welfare looked after by the God. He will have everything done by the Almighty. And there is a witness for this, there is a spectator for this, there is a sakshi for this, and that is Lord Shiva. Every sloka, every action is given a fruit. On one side you say you should not demand the fruit, and another side you yourself prescribe all this. Is it not self-contradictory? Vigneshwara got the doubt. When Vyasa was dictating, karmanyevadhikaraste, you have the right to do the duty, you have no right to expect or demand the fruit. There are two instances in the Gita itself told by Sri Krishna or Vyasa. Mama maya duratyaya, mam eva prapadyante maya metam tarantite. Then Vigneshwara could not complete that sentence, he waited. He wanted a little time. Therefore, he told Vyasa Maharshi, Maharshiji, it is time for Sandhya Vandan. Please stop. I shall go there, worship the evening god, Surya, come back and then take down. Vigneshwara wanted a little time to understand this particular sloka. Such a tough sloka it is. Very difficult it is. In the ordinary lives, if you say you have a duty to do, you do not expect any fruit. Anybody will laugh at us. You pay the money and you don't expect anything from in return. This is something meaningless, ridiculous. Now, there are, Krishna cannot tell a lie. Vyasa cannot tell a lie. And Shastras cannot be false. With that faith we should start. Two things let us say. Cause, effect. There cannot be an effect without cause. Attempt and the fruit. Effort and the fruit. Effort should be there for a fruit. We put in the effort, we get the fruit. It's cause and effect. It is natural. But Krishna says, effort only, no fruit. You put in the effort. That effort is our expectation for a particular fruit. Expectation of the fruit at three levels. Number one, before starting a work, you have the expectation. Before coming to this university, you have an expectation. What is that expectation? I shall become a BSc yoga. I shall become an MSc yoga. I shall become a PhD. This is the expectation of the fruit before coming to the university. If you are a patient or a participant, I am going to Prashant Kutir. I will be staying there for 15 days. I will do all the exercises. I shall obey the instructions of the doctors there. On the 15th day, I will be healthy. I will be healthy is the fruit. We are expecting the fruit for that fruit only. This is first expectation before starting the work. That's called Sankalpa. Two, while doing the work, you have the thought of the fruit. Yes, whatever the doctor has said, I am doing the exercise. Therefore, I must be benefited. It seems one Lord Bhimeshwara was present. Bhimeshwara Swami, Lord Shiva. He made a proclamation. Whoever goes round my temple three times will become pregnant. A lady who does not have children will become pregnant and she will conceive, she will deliver the baby. This is a promise. What is the effort? Go round the temple three times. What is the fruit? You become pregnant or you will conceive. One lady went round the temple one time. She held her hand on the belly. Am I pregnant or not? Second round, am I pregnant or not? Third round, while going round, she was thinking only of the fruit. You have joined BSc yoga. First day class, I am getting BSc yoga. Second class, I am getting BSc yoga. First semester, I am getting BSc yoga. Second semester, I am getting BSc yoga. Always while doing the work, you are remembering the fruit. This is second expectation. Third one, I have completed all the six semesters. I have answered all the questions. I have given a complete attendance. How is it I have not got BSc degree? Why should I not demand? Attitude at the end. So your expectation is at three places. Before starting the work, you expect. While doing the work, you expect. After completing the work, you expect. Sri Krishna's statement, you carefully follow. Mapale, you have right to do the duty, not to demand the fruit. When do you demand? Only after completion of the work. You cannot demand in the beginning. You have to demand it only at the end. That you don't do. Your duty is only to study. Result is in my hands. Your duty is only to serve. Salary is to be given by me. So, Krishna keeps three things in his mind before starting the work. Do you expect or not? Is it right? While doing the work, do you expect or not? Is it right? After completing the work, is it right or not? These steps are to be carefully understood to understand that particular sloka. There is no contradiction. Karmanyevadhikaraste mapaleshu kadachana. You can have sankalpa. Dasaratha Maharaj performed putra kamesti with the expectation of the fruit that he would have children. While doing the work, if you are thinking of the fruit, your concentration fails and you cannot study. After completing, if you expect, there are 100 factors to govern the fruit, and therefore fruit is not necessarily in your hand only. There is a teacher, and a teacher's wife is present. While he is correcting your answer script, his wife may be quarreling with him while answering her, while fighting with her. He doesn't read the answer paper carefully. Out of 10 marks, he will put only 1 mark and you will fail. You have not committed the fault, it is his. There are many factors. So when are we to expect, when are we not to expect, all those things we shall try to discuss later on. Let's meditate on Karma Yogi Sri Krishna.